Welcome back to the SIP Scooter Shop Tutorials channel. Today in the restaurant there is the aperitivo event taking place. And always in the same time in the workshop there is the open dyno event. So it is possible for everyone who wants to have a place on our dyno bench and test his scooter. For us it is the perfect moment to try the engine that we've built in the last episodes and check the power output on our bench. Within the scooter, it's exactly the engine that we've built in the last nine episodes. After building the engine, I've already been to the island of course with this scooter and also with this engine. So it has already a mileage of about 3000 kilometers. The engine is performing quite well. I didn't have any breakdowns. It has a very low fuel consumption and I'm quite happy with it. But anyway, let's have a look at the power graph. Now this is the power graph of the engine. First of all, the sheer maximum horsepower figure is only 22.7 horsepowers. It has more newton meter of torque than it has horsepowers. This is a first identification mark for a quite well and comfortable to drive engine. It has a smooth power band. It revs up to 10,000, even though it pulls nicely in the low rev area. We have this bow, which has almost a shape like an elephant back or like a mountain. And this says that the cylinder and the exhaust are in a good harmony. It used to be a PX80 engine, which is the most cheap to buy here in Germany. We fitted the cylinder only plug and play. We did not do any special tricks or we changed nothing. So it's a plug and play setup and we already have almost 23 horsepowers on the rear wheel, which would be on the crankshaft about 25 horsepowers more or less. And the original engine had only 6 or 7 horsepowers. But you might wonder, there are engines built of the same components. Some are running well and some are running very well. So in the next few episodes of this tutorial, we're gonna have a look at what makes an engine a very good engine and what makes the difference. So we will have a look at the ignition. We're gonna make a comparison between variable timed ignition and static timing ignition. We show you one way to adjust a drum and a flatside race carburetor. Test different exhausts, which have a big influence on the power characteristic and on the maximum power. After that, we're gonna measure the timing of the cylinder and maybe change the cylinder timing. And after that, let's see if we can gain some horsepowers. I'm hoping you're with us with the next episodes. I think it's gonna be really interesting.